Hello, welcome to GM Tech Reviews. Today we are reviewing the Djj Smart Controller. It's not a new product, it came out in March of this year. I've had it since June. The idea here is to see if it's worth still buying it, what can it do, what it cannot do, what's the point of it. As always, if you have any comments or would like to know anything, please leave any questions or comments in the dialog box below. We'll do our best to respond. And we hope you enjoyed this review. First question, we want to know what is it. So you can actually see it is a basic controller. I mean, from first glance, it is very large. You'd be like, why would you want to take this with the drone? I thought the idea with drones is that they get more compact. Well, the idea here is that this is actually a complete all-in-one controller. So in the past with DJI, you've had to connect your phone, your tablet. That's common with most drones, because a lot of drones are built-in screens right now. This gives you a large built-in screen. So this part right here will give you the view of the camera. And you can see this top part is designed exactly like the regular controller. Like you'll connect your two sticks here, which are here on the back, hidden. So you'll take them out of there, you'll connect them to there. You have your power on, you have your return to home, you have your pause button, you have your speed controls here. You have your joystick here, which is the difference between this and the actual controller. So that's an extra button. In the top here, you have in the middle, you have your SD, you have your HDMI out, you have your USB out, and you have your two. This will control the zoom, it will control your zoom. For the Mavic 2 Pro, it will control your on your up and down. You can go up and down, and this controls your zoom. But as I said, the Mavic 2 Pro doesn't have a lot of zoom, so that's not really important. And here you have your camera button and your record button. So the monitor is not that new, or this controller is not that new. It's been out since May last year. I myself have had it since June. And DJI's always had something called the Crystal Sky monitor, but it's just a monitor. So you still needed to take the controller and you needed to carry the monitor around. You still need to connect it with a cable. But the thing is, it connects to all DJI drones. It's not specific to certain type of drones. Like this controller will only work with drones with Aquasync 3.0. Which, as of this moment, includes all the Mavic 2 series, which means the Mavic 2 Pro, the Mavic 2 Zoom, the Mavic Enterprises, and also most recently the Phantom 4 version 2. You have to make sure it's the version 2 because the earlier Phantoms don't have the Aquasync 3.0, how this connects and works. So that was confirmed to me by Flight Path. So if you check out the YouTube of Flight Path, I'll show you how to connect the YouTube 4 version 2 to the controller. So once you've entered the screen, you turn on the power of your controller and everything, you'll get to this screen. One is going to say connect to your drone. You're going to click go to go into your drone connection. It's going to say connect through camera view, or it's going to say connect through cable. Obviously, you're going to connect through the camera view. You're going to click the button on the side, which is the Aquasync 3.0, and it's going to link it automatically. Here, or you're going to have your menu bar, which is going to bring up all your apps. Now, this does use Android. It uses an earlier version of Android. And also, therefore, has no access to the Play Store. So you have to use the Amazon Store or other stores. You can try to get the Play Store on here with an APK, but it is a bit complicated. But as you can see, I have basic apps. I have Facebook on here, Instagram. I have Amazon App Store. I have the DJI Store, which is, you know, the DJI Go app, which is how you fly it, how you connect to it, settings, and internet browser. And it can connect to any internet if you have the internet around. So that's a really good thing. Continuing on this here, you'll have the photos. Depending on how you download your photos, or because as we mentioned earlier, this does take an SD card. So if you have it set up that you take it from the drone to the smart controller SD, you can definitely do that. It also has 8 GB of external memory. So if you put it on the internal, you'd have your photos here. Obviously for me right here, I have them SD card because it's 64 gigs, and as you can see, you're going to wait a second, it's going to pull up the photo. It is a touch screen, or you can also use this little button here, which also will move everything. And as you can see, there are my photos. Wait, pull one up. So there you can see there are my photos. So this screen right here will definitely move it back and forward. So how does this, for example, compare to the Crystal Sky monitor? Well, I've never had a Crystal Sky monitor, so I don't directly know, but from my understanding, this is a full built advantage of the Christmas sky is that it does use external batteries, which this does not. This has a built-in battery right here. You have to charge it through USB-C. That's definitely a disadvantage of this. You can't just take out the batteries from Facebook if you want. So why would you go out and buy this? Well, basically the reason you should buy this, qualities are that it's very useful, especially if you're going to be flying a lot. You don't have to fiddle with cameras. You don't always have to have your phone with you. You can always have your phone as an extra. You can connect this directly to the drone. You can be up and flying in 5 minutes. It's a direct connection. It's comfortable to fly. You can see everything your camera flies. So it's a really good device in that sense. What are the negatives? Well, a couple of the negatives are, one, that if you do lose control, it's quite difficult to fly manually, especially if you don't have any line of sight. Also, the sound is not very good. You have to hold it very, very close to your face to actually get any sound from it. Whereby your mics on your phone are much better. Another advantage is you can do screen recording, which is much more simple because it's directly on this large screen, and you always have a mic accessible. So overall, do I think you should buy it? Well, that really depends on what you're looking to do with it, how often you're looking to fly. If you're looking to fly professionally, how much your hobby is. I think if you're looking to fly professionally, due to the cost of everything, then it's definitely worth buying the device for this. If you're looking to do it more as a hobby, then it's definitely not worth buying the device for this. So I hope you